Good morning all, I am Ujwala Bakshi, a registered dietitian and a diabetes educator. I'm the founder of my company Portion Cure Through Diet, and I am here and very excited to share the news about the new series of videos that I'm going to create, first of which is today, and the topic is essential cooking techniques or cooking smartly in order to derive maximum nutrition from the daily foods that you are eating. So we all are cooking a bowl of rice, we all are making our sets of bread like Indian chapati, or you might be making breads at home, whatever it is, but you need to know how to cook it rightly so that you don't lose out on the essential nutrients that are already there in the food that you are cooking and eating. Now, I came up with this idea especially, so I should really thank the lockdown period and be grateful towards it, because this is the time when I realized that this is something important to be shared, and you know, people should be aware about how they should be cooking, because everybody is cooking nowadays. You know, that's the creative place, the kitchen is a creative place right now, everybody is enjoying the cooking process. But if you are still cooking the you know, the staples wrongly, you're not helping yourself. You're still going to, you know, cook wrongly, lose out on the essential nutrients, and then call for certain nutrient supplements because you realize that, okay, you have been deficient in certain nutrients, right? So, and the two go ingredient, of course, it is easier to cook a bowl of rice than to keep making chapatis or the rotis or the Indian bread or the bread by itself also on a daily basis. So I'm sure many people are looking forward to cooking that bowl of rice, but how it should be cooked in order to prevent those excess starch from the rice to cling along on your body, and you feel that, oh, I have put on weight because of the rice. And that's the fear that many people have. Even if they love rice, they don't want to eat it, or they are fearful of eating rice because they feel that rice, that particular bowl of rice, is not going to help them lose weight, or it is going to increase their blood sugars, or it is going to you know, rampant their health altogether. But many people are not aware that that's not so. If you were to correct one simple thing in the process of cooking rice, you can actually make that bowl of rice work for you. It definitely provides you a lot of nutrition. In fact, not many of you must be aware that rice is actually a better quality protein. So rice has a little amount of protein, which is definitely not at par as that of wheat. But when you eat a bowl of rice, you actually derive or get the type of protein that you get from the rice is of higher quality than that of the wheat. Okay, that's why the rice protein is called as the first class protein. Okay, and that's why the combination of rice and dal in the form of idlis and dosas is considered to be very healthy, because the protein of the rice is beautiful in order to endorse growth in one's health. Okay, so I'm first going to highlight on the type of rice that you should be stocking upon during this lockdown. If you're really thinking of stocking on rice, what kind of rice you should be stocking on so that it doesn't hit your pocket. Okay, secondly, what is that one technique that you should be doing in order to prevent the weight gain that may happen with that bowl of rice? Okay, so very importantly, let me just quickly brush up on the types of rice that are, I'm just going to highlight a very common ones and a very easily available ones. So one is definitely this basmati rice, which is a long grain rice, and this long grain rice is supposed to be one of the healthiest types of rice, but of course it is quite expensive. Okay, basmati rice is expensive, and it is supposed to be healthy because of its long grain structure. You can see it is a long grain structure. Yeah, if you can see this, it's a long grain structure, and it is because of this long grain, it takes a little extra time to cook. Okay, a little extra time to get digested, which helps in also achieving a better glycemic response. That means your blood sugar spike is going to be lesser in accordance to the short grain rice. So here we have a variety of short grain rice. Okay, now this short grain rice, because of its short structure, will get easily digested, and even if you tend to cook it, when you cook it, it will become little starchy. Okay, so now which one should you buy? So of course the basmati rice, if you definitely can afford it, go ahead, look for an aged set of basmati rice, okay? But I will still prefer that if you can go for the brown rice version of the basmati rice, that is definitely the best one. Try to look for the brown rice version. And many people have this concern that, oh, rice, brown rice, it calls for a long time to cook. I really don't have that much time to cook it. I think it's not so. I've tried the basmati brown rice to cook. It doesn't take that much time. Only thing is, definitely you need to be extra smart and alert in terms of, you need to just plan. So anything with respect to health, you need to be pretty much disciplined and planned. You cannot just all of a sudden get up into the kitchen and say, oh, I don't have this, I don't have that, and that's why I'm cooking up a very quick meal, which is not healthy. You have to be disciplined, right? So same thing goes for the brown rice. Cooking a bowl of brown rice, you need to just soak it about an hour or 2 hours before, and you can come up with a bowl of rice. It will definitely take a little longer time to cook, maybe another 10 minutes extra than the white rice. But I think, again, you need to just put it on the stove a little more in advance. Another thing that you can do is simply cook that brown rice in the cooker. So then the cooking happens quite fast. So we have this white rice, which is basmati rice, which is long grain rice. I would suggest, if you're stocking, go for the brown rice version of the basmati rice. If you're going for the short grain version of the rice, then there is this Thai unpolished rice which is available in the market. You can go ahead with that as well. So this is the rice that I generally eat at home. Okay, this is the brown rice of the short grain rice. So it is a mix actually of, they are selling it as basmati rice Thai, the brown rice Thai, brown rice basmati version, but I still feel it's not exactly the basmati rice, because it is not that long grain structure. So going by the visual appearance of this rice, it looks to me that it is still a medium length rice, which is the brown rice version, and this is something that I eat every day. Okay, so yes, another type of rice that you can actually stock on is the most cost effective and is one of the healthiest types of rice, is the parboiled rice. Okay, now parboiled rice is the rice which undergoes a little procedure before it comes to the market and to the shelf. So it goes when you hear the term parboiled, that means it is pre-processed in such a way that it is half cooked, soaked, and then it is dried up, and when it comes to you as a consumer, when you cook it, definitely takes a little longer time again to cook, but at the same time it does not cause that weight gain or the sugar spike after eating rice. So you will feel quite nice and composed after eating parboiled rice. So I would definitely, and it is very cost effective, it is very easily available. So go ahead, if you don't like the brown rice version, there are many clients, you know, psychologically they just don't want to get into this whole idea of the brown rice. So if you really want to avoid it, I would suggest that feel free to go ahead and start eating parboiled rice if you want to go by the appearance of the rice, right? So the recommendation has been yet as brown rice of the basmati version, or it could be the brown rice by itself. It can be also the dry red rice. Okay, if you can really go for the red rice, please go ahead, buy it, stock it, eat it. Okay, it has a lot of B complex vitamins, and the it's much better than the brown rice actually. So red rice is something that you should really, really try if you haven't. You can do a mix of rice, you can do a little bit of brown rice or red rice and cook it together. So I think you will really enjoy it. There is, so in the Singapore market you have these Thai unpolished rice packets which are available, please go ahead, stock on those kind of rice. Okay, something that you should not stock on or you should avoid is definitely the jasmine rice or the sticky rice at this time, because you will end up eating a lot of rice. Being at home, you might, you know, the sight of food may make you go a little extra on the helpings, and then, you know, it will start reflecting on the way. So then please don't come back to me and say, oh, you asked us to eat rice. So definitely you have to really, really look into what kind of rice you are eating. Okay, so one is the type of rice. Second thing that you have to really work upon is the type, is the quantity of the rice. So one fistful of rice. So of course the fist size also differs from person to person. Some people have a big fist, a larger fist. Some people have a smaller fist. So if you feel that, so this is like one fistful of rice. I'll just show you. This is one fistful of rice that I am holding. And of course I've dropped a little extra just to mean, okay, so when I so this much rice I have taken, this is one fistful. Okay, so this one fistful of rice, when I end up cooking, it will give me one bowl of rice. So when you are looking to cook for yourself one portion of rice, it should be one fistful of rice. Okay, now the next very important thing that I was going to share is how to cook the rice in order to make sure that the sugars from the rice does not create more hunger pang, that you feel like eating more, or you don't want to pile up on the weight because of the rice that you love to eat. Okay, so whichever rice you want to eat, be it short grain, long grain, brown rice, whatever rice, of course the preferred is the brown rice, red rice. For those rice, you might not need to use this procedure because they already get the sugars from these type of rice get released into the blood very slowly. But I would suggest that if you, specifically for the white rice, if you're very fond of specific rice and you know you cannot change the type of rice, then this is the technique that you should use to cook that bowl of white rice for yourself. What is it? Simply, while you're cooking the bowl of rice, there are three ways to add fat. That means either oil or ghee. And okay, use either. You can use olive oil, you can use filtered oils. Please go ahead, not to please don't stop add refined oils, only double filtered oils or ghee or unsalted butter. Okay, take a teaspoonful of that fat of preferred choice and add it in the rice. Okay, so you're going to add it in the rice in three manners. You can choose up to you, it's totally up to you how, when do you want to add this spoonful of rice. So either you stir fry the soaked rice. First and foremost, you wash and soak the rice, right? You soak it for at least 30 minutes and then you remove, you take the rice from that bowl of soaked with soaked water. You remove the rice. In the wok, you heat some fat, that is oil or ghee, and then you put this rice, stir fry it, and then you put that, stir fry it for good 2-3 minutes. Okay, when you feel that it has fried a little bit, then you can just add water and start the cooking process. That is one. Second way is you either add this oil in the time of boiling. So when the rice is actually boiling, that is the time you just add that 1 teaspoon of ghee or oil, which is easy. You actually cut short of that stir frying process. Or the third style is the pilaf style, when you cook all the bowl of rice and then you stir fry it. Okay, in a pulao style or a pilaf style. So these are the three ways in which you can add this spoonful of rice and makes a huge difference on your blood sugars. That means it does not let the fat, the oil or the ghee gets absorbed into the rice structure when it is being cooked. Okay, and then when you are eating the rice, it does not release the blood sugars very fast into your system. So that's the reason why it actually helps to give you that feeling of fullness even with a small bowl of rice. So this is one thing. Now many of so first we spoke about the type of rice, then we talk about the cooking process of the rice. Now very important and a very common question that people ask me is, whether do you prefer to cook rice, what would you suggest? Either should I cook the rice in the absorption method, that is just have enough water to cook that exact bowl of rice and there is no leftover water remaining, or would you suggest that you cook the rice in excess water in the Indian traditional manner? So the absorption method is typically used by the other Asians like Japanese, Chinese. They cook that cook their rice in the absorption method. So therein definitely a lot of nutrients are retained, they are not lost. But in the Indian traditional manner, we cook rice typically with a lot of water and we discard that water. Of course, you're losing in a lot of nutrients, but in my but at the same time, you're losing out on the starch as well. So in a good way that you are eliminating the excess starch which is there in the rice. Now my bit is, you can choose whatever procedure you want. I personally prefer the absorption method because I don't want to lose on any nutrients that are there in that bowl of rice. So I don't believe in this idea of cooking the water rice in excess water and discarding it. You are actually just losing out in on the essential nutrients. But in case you want to still follow that procedure, the next idea that I can give you is to simply save on that water. And that water you can use to, so that is full of starch, okay. So initially in the older days, people used to use that rice water, which is also called as mand. That water they used to use to starch their clothes, okay. But that is gone, like it's history now. So what is the next step that you can do instead of discarding? Please don't discard that water. It is loaded with nutrients. It is loaded with B complex nutrients. I would definitely want you not to do it. But of course, for people with arthritis, can prefer to discard that kind of water because it has arsenic as well. And for arthritis, we don't want arsenic into our diet. So you can definitely use the Indian traditional manner and discard that water. Or save that water and use it for the children. Okay. It's not going to hurt. The arsenic is not going to hurt people who don't have arthritis. So try to save on that water and make rasam out of it. Okay, you can simply just chop tomato, put some rasam powder, make a tempering and put it in that rice water and boil it and give it to your family. It is very good for children, specifically in the summer season when they lose a lot of energy while playing, okay, and they need some source of energy to derive. So instead of giving them sugar based drinks, you know, juices and artificial sweetener, artificial drinks or something like that, I would suggest give them this mand. Okay, so this is one way that you can restore the lost nutrients in that rice water. You can give it to your family, give it to yourself. You can actually use it as a post-workout drink as well. So this is something that I wanted to share about rice. I hope you have benefited some way or the other from this entire video. So this is the one technique about rice that I have shared, there are a few techniques that I had shared in this video about the cooking procedures and methods of rice. Let me come up with next video wherein I'll be sharing about some other grains or ingredients, how you should be cooking it in the rightful manner. I hope you enjoyed and you learned something from this video. If you really enjoyed it, please subscribe to my channel. This is something new that I've been thinking, and if you really like it, kindly support the thought so that I can come up with more ideas to share with you and make it a healthier planet in the interest of public health. Thank you so much.